In the previous lecture, I was discussing about telemetry in power system instrumentation. In the previous lecture, I have just gave my lecture on the definition of telemetry, advantages of telemetry, what are the advantages of telemetry over basic communication. After that, the block diagram of telemetry. After that, one important feature, line of sight. After that, we are doing antenna system design and freeze transmission formula. Then this particular thing came actually in the picture, freeze transmission formula. Now in freeze transmission formula, PT and PR, there are two types of power. One is received power, one is transmitted power. Both in the range of either milliwatt or micro or nanowatts. So PR is directly proportional with PT, directly proportional with gain of the transmitting antenna, gain of the receiving antenna, and inversely proportional with the square of the distance of between the transmitting and the receiving antenna. One more thing is over there, that is the wavelength of radiation. With this thing, it is directly proportional, or rather you can say it is directly proportional with lambda square. So if the distance will be much more larger, then of course the received power will be much more less. So in that case, the antenna design should be made in such a way so that there are certain properties like antenna beam efficiency, that should be a very good one. Then there will be antenna power gain, that will be a very good one. Then there will be directive gain, that will be a very good one. Then there will be directivity, it should be having one profound value. With this, there will be antenna beam width, that should cover a large area. So all those things will be coming into account. So these are the thing in freeze transmission formula which should be dealt over here in this telemetry. Now if this freeze transmission formula, if I will just express this formula in terms of decibel or decibel meter, then there will be one term coming in this picture which we can write like this. For that thing, this freeze transmission formula, we are writing it like this, PR divided by PT equal to GT GR lambda square upon 4 pi d square. Why 4 pi? In the previous lecture only I told you that steradian should be the solid angle for a sphere, and for telemetry, whenever there will be antenna wave propagation, we are considering a solid sphere. So now if I will take logarithm in both the sides, and in the form of 20 log of this term, here also if I will take like this, then from there I will get one particular thing which is telling us about the efficiency, about the efficiency of the antenna, about the efficiency related to power gain, etc. Now, of course, operating frequency, as we are talking about wavelength, so operating frequency, if this is the wavelength, the operating frequency is also very important, because we are knowing this fact very well. Lambda equal to C upon F. F is the frequency of propagation, frequency of radio wave propagation. C is the velocity of light. Lambda is the wavelength for propagation. Okay. Whenever we are seeing over here that the exact transmitted power we are not getting in the received power, there will be one particular term we are representing that this as PL. That means path loss or power loss. That particular term is depending on one more factor, which is defined by small n, that is known as path loss exponent. Actually, whenever we will get the power, we are getting some curvilinear fashion in the term of, in the form of exponential type. So we can see over here that depending on this path loss exponent, which will come over here as small n, depending on this path loss exponent, if the value of path loss exponent will be higher, then this ratio which will be much lower. Now this value of n, it will be vary from, n will vary, number one, free space, number two, buildings, number three, factories, number four, hilly area, hilly areas, number five, below the tree, number six, rural area, number seven, urban area, number eight, semi-urban area, so like this, the value of n will be varying. So, in short, we can say that the path loss exponent is a very important factor in terms of path loss. Okay, so now when we will, and we can represent this path loss also, this path loss with respect to path loss exponent, this path loss with respect to distance, if we will plot those things, suppose path loss will be here, distance will be here, then we can see that like this we are getting various types of waveforms. That means an exponential type of things over here. So one more thing is there. Suppose in the, there are several stations which are placed on remote, which are placed in remote areas actually. So whenever the radio waves propagation are coming from there, how the particular thing will be collected at the receiving end? For that, there will be one thing that is known as repeater. Suppose there are three remote stations, just like this. Suppose this is the destination D, this is one remote station R1, this is one remote station R2, and this is one remote station R3. Now suppose here is a particular thing known as repeater. It can come from here to here, it can come from here to here, it can go also like this, it can go also like this. In this case, it will be coming to repeater and going to over here. When it will be happening? Suppose if it will not find this particular destination as a free one, then only this repeater will come into the action. It will go first to the repeater and then it will go to the destination. So this much is about the initials of telemetry. When I will go to the telemetry equipment installation, it will be starting like, of course, the introduction part already I told you. There will be certain system. Number one, for telemetry, it is one very important thing. Whatever data we will get, we have to monitor the quality of the data. And for that, there should be a data acquisition system. That means there is a data collection platform which will collect the data, which will store the data, which will encode the data, which will transmit the data further. To what? To any sensor, any data logger, etc. Now there will be a signal transmission system. That signal transmission system is a type of equipment that is needed to transmit the data from one host or from one ground station to the data collection platform, or you can say from data collection platform to the host or ground state. That may be any type of satellite also. So this is the starting. Now what are the types of wireless telecommunication in terms of telemetry? As I told before also, there will be in the morning session when I give my lecture, in the previous lecture I told that there will be some telemetry which is depending on VHF 150 to 174, we have seen over there, that is the megahertz of range. Then there will be UHF 450 to 470, or rather you can start from 420, it will go up to 470, and there are 900 megahertz band also, which will go going up to 960 megahertz. There will be cellular telephony, there will be spread spectrum telemetry, and there will be satellite telemetry. And satellite telemetry we are using for remote monitoring sites. We can use satellite telemetry over there where there will be no cellular coverages. Of course, cellular telephone system where we cannot apply actually, or we can use for those distant locations which are placed at very remote places. So we can tell it over here that there will be several types of telemetry, just like VHF and UHF, number one, number two cellular, number three satellite. All these are very important type of telemetry. Of course, there will be spread spectrum telemetry also. And all these things are coming under certain things. Just like there will be one known as voltage telemetry. We have to see the input and output voltage associated with the system. Second one is current telemetry. Third one is power telemetry. Fourth one is time telemetry. So these are the things which are very important in nature. So whenever we will be making the data collection platform equipment, what are the things that we'll be dealing? DCP or data collection platform equipment. Now, what are the things? So, number one, multi-parameter, that means which is associated with many parameters. Multi-parameter Sunday. Number two, there will be enclosure. Number three, there is logger or transmitter. Number four, there is power supply. Number five, there will be GPS antenna. Number six, there will be antenna, maybe directive, maybe omnidirectional. All these things is the part of DCP. Now, power supply is actually connected with three different things. One is solar panel, one is regulator, one is battery. Clear? There will be several types of GPS antenna, there will be several types of antennas that can be used for this thing. Now, what are the factors that is very important for designing a telemetry network? First of all, is the architecture of the system. Architecture of the system means we have to know about the constituent for one particular telemetry system, their working principle, as well as their characteristics, their application, etc., in which purpose they will be used. Number two, implementation horizon, that means where we can use all those type of things in a telemetry network. How we can implement them, where we can implement them. Number three, system requirements in terms of number one, the location and the number of DCP, that means data collection platform. What should be the location of data collection platform? If there will be multiple number, what should be the exact number of data collection platforms along with their locations? And the transmission frequency, if it will be short time scenario or it will be long time scenario, then what will be the transmission frequencies for short distance communication, for long distance communication? Then system integration and customization requirements. If I need all those things in an integrated network within a customized environment, how I can implement, how I can proceed. Then system installation requirements. Just to install that system, what are the basic requirements? If I have to install that telemetry system in a remote location or in a local location or in a local site, what are the requirements? Then redundant transmission of data, of course, if it is necessary, then only it will be used. Then the cost of network installation, that is another very important thing, because economy is one of the most profound thing related with telemetry. Then what should be the support and maintenance? What should be the provision for troubleshooting if this system is not working properly? Cost of the transmission service for this telemetry based data transmission, what should be the cost? Then data management, that actually what data management requirements means data collection as well as quality control, quality assurance analysis, data processing, system management, user interface, data dissemination. So all these things will be coming under this. And last of all, you should know this thing, that if all these things will be properly optimized, then only the telemetry system will be, or telemetry network will be working smoothly. Now, installations guidelines. Installation activities, actually it is divided into two parts. One part, activities that place before going to the field, and the second part, the activities should be done on site. So these are very important two things. One is the type of prerequisite, other is the type of necessary action depend upon the requirement. So these are the two very important things. So we should know about the type of the telemetry system that to be installed, type of monitoring platform and monitoring site location. So all these things are very important thing. Now pre-installation activities, that is also a very important thing. For pre-installation activities, antenna consideration is one of the important thing. What type of antenna we will use over here, that is a very important consideration. I say whether it will be a GPS antenna, whether it will be a directive, whether it will be an omnidirectional antenna. Along with that, power equipment, that is a very important thing. Then monitoring, for monitoring work, what should be the monitoring platform requirements. And along with that, one more thing will be there, development of an installation part or development of the installation plan. After that, power equipment considerations will come. In the power equipment considerations, two things are very, very important. One is power consumption of the system. Second one is battery consideration. Along with that, of course, there will be solar panel. There will be solar panel consideration. What are the basic requirements for the installation of solar panel? And if there will be any type of solar radiation involved in this, for that, what are the basic requirements? What should be the fixed orientation for solar panel? What should be the adjusted orientation for solar panel? All those things will be coming over there. Suppose, if at all, there will be any unwanted bird spikes, that means if any unwanted attack from birds in the line of sight within the on the solar panel or in the antenna region, then how we can troubleshoot all those things. After that, the monitoring platform will come along with the antenna consideration, and then comes the installation plan. Installation activities is a very important another thing. And whenever we will be mounting the telemetry equipment, how they will be mounted, how the enclosure installation is being done, so all those things are very important feature. How the telemetry equipment mounted on antenna tower, all these are of profound consideration. There will be another additional installation considerations which should be taken into the picture. So in this way, telemetry equipment is being installed either on an antenna or just in front of a solar panel to give a fruitful data transmission. So here ends the telemetry. In my next lecture, I will just go to some brief, I will just briefing some points related to this installation and monitoring of telemetry equipments, along with some advantages and disadvantages of this installation platform.